Hello folks, Prasad Domala here. In this video, I'll show you how you can use AWS CodePipeline to automate your application releases on AWS Cloud, which is also called as continuous delivery in DevOps terminology. So continuous delivery is the process of automating software releases, and it is the main building block of DevOps philosophy. We can achieve continuous delivery using AWS CodePipeline, and it helps us to design, visualize, and automate the steps required for application or software releases. We can also incorporate manual approvals at different stages if you want human intervention for any critical production releases in your AWS CodePipeline. So before starting the demo, let me briefly introduce you to various stages in CodePipeline. There are three main stages when it comes to implementing continuous delivery using CodePipeline: source, build, and deploy. And we can optionally have manual approval stage as well if you wish to. So as of recording this video, CodePipeline supports GitHub, AWS CodeCommit, and Amazon S3 as source repositories. And we'll be using GitHub as our application source in today's demo. And coming to the build phase, it supports Jenkins, AWS CodeBuild, and Solano continuous integration tools. So for our sample application, we don't need any build, so we'll not be using any of these tools for this demo. And for the deploy phase, CodePipeline supports AWS Elastic BeanStalk, AWS Code Deploy, and AWS Cloud Formation. And in our demo, we'll be using Elastic BeanStalk to deploy our test PHP application. You can also automate your CloudFormation stack creation using CloudFormation as your deployment provider. And that will be extremely helpful if you want to implement continuous delivery for your infrastructure. And for manual approvals, you need to create a SNS topic with email subscription so that you can receive email notifications. So in our demo today, we'll be deploying a simple PHP application which uses GitHub as a source repository. And we'll be using Elastic BeanStalk to deploy our PHP application. Once the initial PHP code is deployed, we'll make changes to the code and push it to GitHub. And AWS CodePipeline will pick up those changes and deploy it to our Elastic BeanStalk on AWS. So here I have an application with a single PHP page, which outputs some text. So it has a heading and it echoes the version number. I have it on my GitHub repository here. As you can see, I have my phptest.php page. So first, let us deploy our application to Elastic BeanStalk. So here I am logged into my AWS console. So I'll go to Elastic BeanStalk under Compute section, and then click on Get Started. So I'll just call my application as my PHP app. And then you need to choose a platform. In our case, it would be PHP. And for application code, I'll be uploading my own code. I have already created a zip file, so I'll just upload it. I have it on my desktop, and then upload. So once you upload your code, you can just click on create application. So it'll take a few minutes to create our BeanStalk environment. So I'll pause the video here and I'll get back when our environment is created completely. Okay, now our environment is created successfully and the health is looking good. So we'll have a URL for our application. So let's access our PHP page. So this is the URL. And then slash my PHP test dot PHP. So this is our test page, and the version, as you can see, it is version 1 now. Now let's use CodePipeline to do our future deployment. So let's go to CodePipeline console and create a new pipeline. So go to services, under developer tools, go to CodePipeline, then click on get started. And then I'll call my pipeline as my PHP pipeline. And then click on next. So here you need to provide a source provider. So in our case, it would be GitHub. So select that. And next, you need to connect to your GitHub account. So click on connect to GitHub here. I'm already logged into GitHub, so it will be connected automatically. So you need to select your repository. So in my case, it is my PHP app, and then the branch would be master. So select your repository and branch, and then click on next. Next, you need to provide a build provider. So in our case, I will not have any build. So I'll just select no build, and then click next. So next, you need to provide a deployment provider. So these are the three stages which I was talking about earlier, source, build, and deploy. So in our case, the deployment provider would be Elastic BeanStalk. So select that. So you need to provide an application name here. So once you click on the application name text box, it will list down all the BeanStalk applications available in your account. So let's select our application, which is MyPHP app. And for environment name, we only have one environment. So I'll select that and then click next. Next, we need to specify IAM service role. So this role is to provide permissions to your code pipeline to use resources in your account. So I already have my service role created, so I can use it. So if you're creating your pipeline for the first time, you can create your service role, you know, right from the screen by clicking on create role button here. So I already have my service role created, so I'll just use that existing service role, which is AWS code pipeline service. So select that and then click next. Here you can review your pipeline configuration. And if you're happy with your configuration, you can click on create pipeline. So our pipeline is created now, and it will show you a nice visual representation of all your pipeline phases. So for our demo, we only have source and deploy phases. So you can edit this pipeline as well and add additional steps if required. And this pipeline will be triggered automatically. And for the first time, it will pull the version 1 and deploy it to our Elastic BeanStalk. As you can see, it started our source step. So it will pull your latest code from GitHub and then deploy it to your Elastic BeanStalk. So we'll wait for a couple of minutes for the steps to complete. So I'll just pause the video. So now the source step is completed. You can see the status message here, succeeded. And if you click on this link here, it will directly take you to your GitHub repository. So this is the repository which was used by our code pipeline. And the next step will start automatically. As you can see, our Elastic BeanStalk deployment step is in progress. Okay, so now both our steps are successful now. So at this stage, if we access the application again, it will still be version 1. Because we haven't made any changes. So if you refresh this page, it's still version 1. Now let's make a change to our PHP page and push it to GitHub. I'll just go to my editor and I'll just change this to version 2 and I'll push it to GitHub. I'll just commit it as version 2. Okay, let me save this file first. Okay, and then push it to our master branch. Okay, it's done now. Now if you go back to our pipeline, so the first step, which is source step, should be triggered automatically. Give it a couple of minutes and it will be triggered automatically, and it will pull down the latest code from GitHub and deploy it automatically to your Elastic BeanStalk application. If you want to manually trigger the pipeline, you can click on this release change button here, which will trigger the pipeline automatically. As you can see, it's triggered now. Our source step is in progress. Let's give it a couple of minutes for both the steps to complete. Okay, the source step is successful now. As you can see, the version is version 2, and now our deployment step is in progress. Okay, both our steps are successful now. So let's go back to our application and refresh it. As you can see, the version is now changed to version 2. So our PHP application is now configured for continuous delivery. So whenever you do any change and push it to your GitHub repository, so that code will be pulled by your code pipeline and will be automatically deployed to your Elastic BeanStalk. And adding manual approvals is a good idea if you want to restrict the changes, especially in your production environments. So let me quickly show you how to add manual approval by editing our existing code pipeline. As I said, we need to have SNS topic to send email notifications to approver. So let's create a topic quickly. So I'll go to my SNS console and then create a topic. I'll just call as PHP app and then create a topic, and I'll just create a subscription, which is email subscription. So I'll just select the protocol as email, and then endpoint I'll just provide my email ID and then create subscription. So we'll be using this particular topic to send approval notifications to our approvers. So it says pending confirmation, so I need to confirm my email ID. So I'll just quickly do that and come back. So this is how a subscription confirmation email looks like. So I have confirmed my email subscription. So if we refresh it here, we'll see the subscription ID. So now let's get back to our code pipeline console and then edit our pipeline. So click on edit here. As you can see here, we have our existing two steps. So we'll add a new step in between. So before deploying the changes, we need a manual approval. So let's create a manual approval stage, and let's call it as say manual approval. Then add an action. So the action category would be approval in our case. So select approval, and then you need to provide an action name. I'll just call it as approve, and then the approval type would be a manual approval. We have only one option here. So select manual approval, and then it will ask you for your SNS topic. So in our case, we have created our SNS topic, which is called as PHP app. So select that and then click on add action. Okay, and then save pipeline changes. Okay, our pipeline is updated now. Now let's make another change to our test PHP page and then push it to GitHub. So I'll just change the version to version 3 and then push it to GitHub. Okay, it's now pushed to our GitHub repository. Now let's get back to our code pipeline console. Now our source step should be triggered automatically. Okay, it's in progress now. Okay, the source step is successful. Now the manual approval stage will be triggered. The status is waiting for approval. So I might have received an email asking for the approval. And this is how an approval email looks like. And we'll have, I guess, 1 week to approve this request. So you can click on review here. It'll ask you to provide a comment. I'll just say approved. And then you'll have an option to approve or reject. In our case, it would be approved. So once you approve it, the next step, which is deployment to our Elastic Beanstalk, will be started. As you can see, the deployment step is in progress now. Okay, the deployment step is complete now. So let's refresh our test page. And we should be able to see our version 3. So that's it, guys. You now know how to create AWS code pipeline to achieve continuous delivery of your application. So if you have any questions or suggestions, please post them in the comments. Hope you liked the video and found it helpful. So please hit that like button if you did, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos on cloud computing. And that's it for today, and see you in the next one.